My strength, my song, this cornerstone, the solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand.
In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live.
There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ.
No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny.
No power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I stand.
Good evening and welcome to worship. I appreciate so much these opportunities for us to come together and worship, even if it's virtually. I want to thank you for staying connected with us through all of this. And I am so grateful for our musicians tonight. I want to let you know who they are. This would not be possible and near as special if it weren't for them. I want to thank Pastor Ben, Joel Qualm, Ian Heseltine, Gary Johnson, and Paula Odlin. Thanks so much for helping tonight. We had a great Easter worship on Sunday. I was able to blow the old cobwebs off the old kazoo with Pastor Carey, and that was a lot of fun. And in fact, you know, we're not done celebrating Easter, right?
No.
We continue. We need Easter. We need Easter during these days. And I just thought, you know, maybe as we start our gathering song, would you guys mind if I just happen to have my kazoo with me. Would you mind if I join you?
Guys, what do you think?
No.
Oh.
No offense, Pastor Greg.
Okay.
You can put the cobwebs back.
All right. I'll keep practicing, though. All right?
You keep practicing.
Yeah.
Keep practicing.
Okay. We sing together because he lives.
Amen. Amen.
I was dead in the grave. I was covered in sin and shame. I heard mercy call my name. He rolled the stone.
We worship because he lives. We have the ability to confess our sin and know that we can find forgiveness and mercy and grace in Christ. So as we continue, we want to take just a moment of silence to reflect and to get our hearts right with God. Let's do that right now. God, we confess that more often than not, we fail to live out the good news of the resurrection. Tonight, we confess the wrong we've done and the good we've failed to do. And we ask you that you would forgive us, that you'd renew us, and that you'd lead us. In Jesus' name, amen. And hear this good news that's given for you. God is gracious. God is merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. Through Christ's death and resurrection, we are given a living hope. We're given newness of life. Let us rejoice and be glad. In the name of Jesus, amen. We pray together our prayer of the day. God of mercy, we no longer look for Jesus among the dead, for he is alive. Pour into our hearts the risen life we share with Christ, and help us to grow as your people. Christ is risen, and we are changed. Send us today with glad and generous hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our gospel reading this evening comes again from Mark, the 16th chapter. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he's going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Well, good evening and happy Easter. I'm Pastor Ben, and like Pastor Greg said as we began, I am so glad that you are with us tonight. We pray that this time is a time for you to remember God's promises for you, to remember the promises of Easter, that God is alive in this world and God's presence really, truly is all around us. There's been a lot in the headlines lately, and I won't rehash it all, but one topic in the headlines has been really interesting to me. It's something that people have stocked up on, and that topic isn't toilet paper. It's yeast. There are a lot of people who have been isolating at home lately. Of course, there are some who can't, some who need to be out doing the things that can't be done from home. We're grateful for those people who are in the thick of it. Still, lots are at home, and we're grateful for that as well. Of those who are at home, many are looking to start a new hobby, and for a lot of people, that hobby is bread baking. So yeast is in high demand. It's really hard to find. I don't even know where you could get it. Fortunately, we had some before all this began, and we've been doing a lot of cooking, and my wife, Alyssa, has been making bread. There's nothing better than that. We have some yeast. But my sister has not been so fortunate. She's been looking for it everywhere. Before she started isolating at home, she tried to get it at the store, and they were sold out. Since she started working from home and doing grocery pickup or having things delivered, she's tried numerous times to add it into her virtual cart, and sometimes there's been this tiny little glimmer of hope that there might be some, but every time she has been denied. No yeast for her. And our family's heard all about it on our family text chain or in our Zoom talks. Most of the family has offered condolences, but since I'm her older brother and will always feel the need to tease, I just make sure that she has enough pictures of the fresh homemade bread that we have been eating. Older brothers and this pandemic have pushed many of us to our limits, to points of frustration in small ways. We can't get the things that we need. There's no yeast to start that new hobby, but it's touched us in ways that are much bigger than that. That trip that needed to be canceled, athletes who couldn't finish a season or start one, time with friends taken away, and other ways too. It's elderly people who are having to spend their days alone, having their meals dropped off at their doors. It's families who can't remember and honor a loved one with a funeral service. It's businesses that have had to close their doors. It's people who are out of work and unable to provide for their families. It's not being able to visit a sick friend or family member in the hospital. This is tough stuff. As I've talked to people, I've come to realize in so many ways that people have been pushed to the end of their rope. And that loneliness and worry and uncertainty for some have taken over. Life can do that. I've heard many times lately that we are living in unprecedented times, and that's true. It's unlike anything we've ever seen before. But life is always unprecedented. It always throws things our way that we don't know how to handle, things that worry us, things that scare us, things that push us to the edge of our rope, these places that are torn and tattered and frayed. Life is always filled with struggles that surprise us. It's coming in bigger waves right now. And I think we're hyper aware that the wall between the life that we hold dear and chaos or something like it is thinner than we thought. It always has been. I think tonight of those women who made their way to the tomb on that first Easter morning. And I would be willing to guess that they had reached the end of their rope. Mark's gospel tells the story of Jesus in almost fast-forward motion. Jesus begins his ministry, and immediately people are amazed at this man who has this authority and the power of God to heal and forgive. It's good news for God's people who were worn down and worried and afraid and hungry and ready for a different way of life. It's good news. So they follow him. They love him. They call him their king. But it didn't last. The religious authorities and the Roman government, they were afraid of this man, afraid that his good news of forgiveness and love and the kingdom of God was more powerful than their laws and their traditions, and so they had him killed, crucified on a cross. The death of a criminal. And the people like us, let it happen. 3 days after his death, these women who had loved Jesus, who had learned from Jesus, who were changed by Jesus, who had placed their hope in him, they walked slowly that Easter morning to this tomb where his body had been laid. And they were worried about everything. They were worried that God had abandoned them, that tomorrow would somehow be worse than today. They even worry about how they're going to move this big stone that Jesus was behind in the tomb. How would they even move that when they got there? Well, these worries quickly subside, and I would guess that new ones arose because the stone was gone. So was Jesus. The tomb is empty. And I can't imagine that it all made sense to them in that moment. But they're at the end of their ropes, where their fears and sadness overwhelmed them. The empty tomb said to them, loudly and clearly, that God was not done with them. That God was not done with this world. The risen Christ means for those women and for us that God is alive whether we see it or not. An empty tomb means that forgiveness and love and hope are alive even right there in the middle of death. The Easter message that first morning and tonight is that a spark lives in us and it moves in us. Christ lives in us and gives us strength and peace in the face of things that we can't handle and things that we can't understand. The empty tomb is this promise that God loves us so much that he came into this world and goes to the end of the rope, even to death, to say that Jesus has the power to overcome everything in this world. One day my sister and her husband decided that during this pandemic they would clean out their kitchen cupboards. And once they'd emptied their pantry, guess what they found in the very back of the shelf? A few packets of yeast. The Easter promise is that all of us will find a little yeast. Maybe not literally, because it's really hard to come by right now. but we will find the hope and the encouragement in the risen Christ that will give us the spark that we need, the lift that we need to face these days. I read a story the other day about a man named Bill. Bill operates a lumber mill in Tennessee, and this pandemic has taken a lot away from him. He's lost two friends. He lost his pastor, who had guided him through some really difficult times in this life. He had to let lots of people go at his lumber mill, and he's struggling to keep that business going. It seems like everything is against him, but Bill is making it, and he's hopeful, and he's remaining positive and optimistic, and that's because of one thing: faith. Bill doesn't trust himself. He knows that he can't rely on this world. He's discovered through many struggles and failures that only God can carry him through. And this is what Bill said of his faith. He said, "I ask God every night to continue to grant me two things: his presence, so I know I'm not alone in this, and his strength." For Bill, God's presence and God's strength are enough. They are the yeast that sparks him to continue on. The empty tomb, the Easter promise, says just that. That at the end of our ropes, God is present with us always, and that God's strength is our strength. I hope that you can remember that promise that we proclaimed on Easter Sunday. And I hope that you remember that it's not just for one day, but that God's promise in Christ is for each and every day. Each and every day it's brand new. Each and every morning, no matter what the world says. Let that promise grow within you. Let it strengthen you even now. That simple promise: Christ is risen. Happy Easter again. Amen.
The moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, his blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon him. Heaven took away, the Son of God was laid in darkness. A battle in the grave, a war on death was waged, the power of hell forever broken. The ground began to shake. The stone was rolled away. His perfect love could not be undone.
sing hallelujah, the Lamb is overcome. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb is overcome. Forever He is glorified, forever He is lifted high, forever He is risen, He is alive, He is alive. The ground began to shake, the stone was rolled away, His perfect love could not be overcome.
Tonight we take these next moments to lift our voices in song and as well as in prayer. And this evening we want to remember the family of Carol Sonstebe, who passed away this week. We begin by singing the peace prayer, and we'll respond to our prayers by singing this again after each petition. We sing together.
Light before us, light behind us, light under our feet. Light within us, light over us, let all around us be light.
God of all mercy and grace, we give you thanks tonight that you have come into this world. You lived for us and you died for us. Let truth be the one that defines us each and every day. Today, we are grateful that you are alive and that you're at work in this world. We thank you that even now you work through those on the front lines of this pandemic. Watch over all who leave home to do the essential things each day. Protect all of us and give each one your strength. Hear us as we sing.
Light before us, light behind us, light under our feet. Light within us, light over us, let all around us be light.
You are the light that goes before us. You are the light that shines in our darkness. This evening we ask that you would watch over those who suffer. Encourage those who are lonely and worn out. Heal those who are sick. We remember those on our prayer list today and lift before you Linda Holcomb, Kayla Schmidt, Tom Scarcy, Bob Brown, Diane Larson, Warren Olson, Arlen Davis, Callie Olson, George Dearsted, Sawyer Frorup. Comfort all who are dealing with grief these days. We pray for Bryce and Mary Shercliffe on the death of Bryce's brother Scott. We remember Elaine Kunow and her family on the death of Elaine's sister, Cheryl. And we pray for the family and friends of Carol Sonstebe. You are the risen Lord. Because you live, we live also. Hold us in your promises today and hear us as we sing.
Light before us, light behind us, light under our feet. Light within us, light over us, let all around us be light.
You have been incredible through these days. Your support, your prayers, your cards and notes that you've sent to us. Yes, we read them, we receive them, and they bring us so much encouragement. Thanks so much for reaching out to us and for allowing us to reach out to you. We had no idea how all of this would go as we'd make our way through these days, but we are learning that not only is God faithful, but all of you are so faithful. If you're able to give a gift these days, we thank you so much for that. There are a few ways that you can do that on the screen tonight. And again, we thank you for your gift. Let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive this blessing. May the one who brought forth Jesus from the dead raise you to new life, fill you with hope. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Well, I don't know about you, but I sometimes feel like I have simply lost track of time during these days. We have been doing worship just like this for over 3 weeks now. Hard to believe. And it looks like we're going to continue to do this, for at least for the foreseeable future. We ask that you would hang in there with us. We know it's not exactly how we want it to be, but we want you to know that we care about you. We want you to avail yourselves of the different options that we provide. You can learn about those at our website, on Facebook. In fact, we send out an e-newsletter. We've had quite a few people who've signed up for that just over this past week. And if you'd like to be a part of that, if you'd like to receive our e-news, simply go to our website and you can sign up easily there. If you have questions, if you need to talk, reach out. We'd love to be there for you. Now as we go, we ask that God would bless you and use you, and we sing together our sending song. body of Christ, raised up for the world. Go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God. And all God's children said, Amen. Amen.